expecting for you all.
Trying to come,
but network problem is there. Sorry, ma'am.
If it is other than network problem, then solve that problem.
Okay,
if
ma'am.
It is not your excuse, then try to come in the scheduled time. So it is 44 now. So just waiting 1 minute more. Priyanshu Barman.
Yes, ma'am.
And Richa Kumari. So both of you are late. 5 minutes late. Why?
Ma'am, my network problem.
Network problem. What was happening to your network?
It's not too slow.
Now is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so all of you are present now. Now just call by your roll number. Roll number 1.
Yes, ma'am.
2.
Present, ma'am.
3.
Present, ma'am.
4.
Present, ma'am.
5.
Present, ma'am.
6.
Present, ma'am.
7.
Present, ma'am.
8. Roll number 8. What is your name, roll number 8?
Ma'am, audience.
9.
Present, ma'am.
10.
Present, ma'am.
11.
Present, ma'am.
12.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14.
Present, ma'am.
15.
Present, ma'am.
16. Roll number 16. Roll number 16. 17.
Present, ma'am.
18.
Present, ma'am.
19.
Present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
21.
Present, ma'am.
22.
Present, ma'am.
23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am.
25.
Present, ma'am.
Pranay Gupta, want to say anything? So after which I roll number 26, ma'am. 27.
Present, ma'am.
28.
Present, ma'am.
29.
Present, ma'am.
30.
Present, ma'am.
31.
Present, ma'am.
34.
Present, ma'am.
33.
Present, ma'am.
34.
Present, ma'am.
35.
Present, ma'am.
36.
Present, ma'am.
37.
Present, ma'am.
38.
Present, ma'am.
39.
Present, ma'am.
40. Roll number 40.
Present, ma'am.
41.
Yes, ma'am.
42.
Yes, ma'am.
43.
Present, ma'am.
44.
Yes, ma'am.
45.
Yes, ma'am.
So initially 46 was total attendance. Now it is showing 45, including me. Actually, it will be 46, including me. So now it is showing 45. So one student is now left the meeting. Roll number 16, I am not getting. Are you here? Roll number 16. Roll number 16. So roll number 16 initially entered into the meeting. Now he is not here. Yes, Shreshi, I don't know. Not here. So roll number 16, I will make you absent. Again, at the end of my class, I will check you are here or not, roll number 16. if any network issue is there and your voice is not coming to me, then at the end I will check again this roll number. Now going for my presentation for this class. Now the sharing screen is visible or not?
Yes, ma'am, visible.
Okay. Now today I will discuss what is divergence. Let V function of x, y, and z, that I am writing this as v1 I hat plus v2 j hat plus v3 k hat, be defined and differentiable at each point x, y, z in a shortened region of space. That is, V defines a differentiable vector field. You can see this is vector field. Yesterday I took gradient of phi. Phi was scalar, but here what is this? This is differentiable. This V is differentiable at each point x, y, z in a shortened region of space. And V defines one vector field. You can see vector sign is here. So this is differentiable vector field. Then the divergence of V, what we can write? The divergence of V written as div of V. V, that is vector, that is given by this arrow mark. And it is defined as divergence of V. Divergence and this sign, dot means here, this dot sign as it is here. So I am writing, and this symbol, it was del operator, and here it can be used for gradient, divergence and curl, all these three. Now I am expressing it by divergence. So divergence of V, what is this? So I am writing the meaning of this. What is this? This is I hat del del x plus j hat del del y plus k hat del del z. Now what is V? V is V1 I hat plus V2 j hat plus V3 k hat. So just I am writing this. Now again, I hat dot I hat, and you know it, the value is 1. J hat dot J hat, the value is 1. And K hat dot K hat, the value is 1. So del del x of what? V1. So del V1 by del x. Now del del y of V2. That is what? Del V2 by del y. And del del z of V3. What is this? This is del V3 by del z. Because here it is I hat del del x. When it is operating on this, only I hat as I hat dot I hat exists. So it will only operate on V1. So del del x of V1. And when del del x of I hat, if I take V2 j hat, then I dot j, the value is 0. And I dot k, the value is 0. So I am not considering next two terms for this I hat del del x. So only the first term I am considering. In the same way, when del del y of j hat will operate on this hole, then only j dot j, that means this j and this j, dot product is 1. So I'm only getting del del y of V2 and rest 2. That is the first term and the last term. The value you will get it at 0. And in the same way for the third term. So for the first two, the value will be 0, and it will only for the third one. So del V3 by del z. So this is divergence of V equal to this. Now we have to note this. If this is not true, that is divergence of V, that is not equal to V dot divergence. That means you can't write this. Now the physical significance of divergence of A. Now if A represents the velocity of a moving fluid at a point P, then divergence of A gives the rate at which the fluid is diverging per unit volume from the point P here. If divergence of A, that this is greater than 0 at any point P, then either the fluid is expanding or its density at P is decreasing with time, or the point P is the source of the fluid. If divergence of A, it is less than zero, then either the fluid is contracting or its density is increasing at P, or the point is a sink. You have to remember all these points. If divergence of A equal to zero, that means you have A, you are taking the divergence A is a vector. Now you are taking the divergence of A, then you are getting the value, and after estimating or calculating, you are getting the value as zero. Then the flux of A entering any element of space is exactly balanced by the flux leaving it. Then there is no source or sink in the field, nor its density is changing. That means the fluid is incompressible. A vector A which satisfies this condition is called the solenoidal vector. So if you are getting the divergence of A equal to zero, then we can say that vector A is the solenoidal vector. So these points are very important. So A represents the, if A, that is the vector, represents the velocity of a moving fluid at a point P, then divergence of A gives the rate at which the fluid is diverging per unit volume from the point P. So remember this one as the physical significance of divergence. And remember, if we get divergence of A equal to zero, then it is called a solenoidal vector. And remember this one, if divergence of A is less than zero, then either the fluid is contracting or its density is increasing at P, or this is the point of sink. And if divergence of A equal to zero, the flux of A entering any element of space is exactly balanced by the flux leaving it. So flux entering the volume equal to the flux leaving the volume. So this is divergence of A, and divergence of A equal to zero, it is the meaning is the vector is solenoidal in nature. Now these are different pictorial representation of divergence of A. So this is, say, the first one A, this is the positive divergence. You can see it is going out of this point P. This is the point P, this is the point P, which I was mentioning. Now flux that is going outside, and it is coming inside to the point P. So this is positive divergence. This figure is known as positive divergence. B, this is negative divergence. This is the figure of negative divergence. And this is zero divergence. This is zero divergence. C is the zero divergence. So divergence of A less than zero, the fluid is contracting. Contracting means this one. This one. The fluid, flow is towards the point P. So the fluid is contracting. Here the fluid is expanding. It is going out of the point P. So divergence of A greater than zero at any point P, if it is, then either the fluid is expanding, the fluid is expanding and its density at P is decreasing with time, and the point P is the source of the field. So either the fluid is expanding, the divergence of A greater than zero. So the fluid is expanding and density is decreasing. Here the fluid is expanding, the density is decreasing. This is positive divergence. This is positive divergence means what? Positive divergence means divergence of A what? Greater than zero. Okay. Divergence of A greater than zero at any point P, then either the fluid is expanding, you can see that it is going outside from this point. The fluid is what? Expanding. The fluid is expanding. So, and P is the source of the fluid. Is it true now? From this point, it is coming. So P is what? Source of the fluid. Density is decreasing and P is the source of the fluid and the fluid is expanding. And here what is happening? The fluid is contracting. Understand? All of this is coming to this point. So the whole thing is contracting. Here it is contracting. So negative divergence. And it is sink. So it is what? Sink point. And it is source point. All these things coming to this point P. So it is sink point and it is source. That means everything is coming out of this. So this is the source point. Fluid is expanding, fluid is contracting. Positive divergence and this is negative divergence and this is zero divergence. And if divergence of Z is zero, then if A is any vector and divergence of A equal to zero, then what is the name of the vector? Just I said?
Solenoidal vector.
Solenoidal vector. So if it is given mathematically, this problem is given. Proof that a particular vector is solenoidal or not. Then what you have to find out? You have to find out divergence of that vector and you have to calculate. And if you are getting zero value, then you can say that the vector is solenoidal. If not, then not. Now, one problem I'm coming here for one problem. Now, just I'm using again whiteboard. So after that, I will use. Just I'm telling you first. So divergence of what is? So it is bold. That is the one vector sign you have to write. What you have to write? One vector sign. So when you will write in your copy, then you will write it. So what is the meaning of this? The meaning of this is I hat del del x plus j hat del del y plus k hat del del z dot vector r by r cube, that is equal to zero. You have to probe this. The divergence of this, what I was saying that A, it was initially I was saying that divergence of A, say A equal to, not I will not say A because A I have written some different thing. So if you write it, divergence of B equal to zero, proof. So B is what? B is vector R by R cube. This is the mod value, remember. And this is the bold sign. So what is the meaning of this? This is R equal to XI hat plus YJ hat plus ZK hat. Now, what I have taken? I have taken phi equal to R to the power minus 3. I can take this because I told you this RQ is not a vector. This is the mod value. So phi actually, you know, scalar. So I am writing this one as phi. So R cube. So 1 by R cube, I am taking as phi. So R to the power minus 3. That is phi equal to 1 by R cube. I am taking this. And what I am taking? A is a vector I am taking. And the value is A equal to vector R. Vector A equal to vector R. Whenever you will write in your copy, always give the vector sign. You can't write, don't write in bold, in this way, bold as a sign. So A equal to R. So vector A equal to vector R. Vector, I'm saying that always you will give vector sign, upper A. So vector A equal to vector R. So what you are getting, actually divergence of this thing, that is equal to, that you have to find out. So divergence of what you will get? 1 by R cube is what? 1. So divergence, so here divergence of, so this divergence of which? R by R cube. So what is R cube? 1 by R cube? Written. What is 1 by R cube?
Pi.
And what is vector R?
A.
So divergence of phi, A. That this is. Now this is the formula. Mathematically, this is the formula. No need to prove it now. So you will remember this formula. Divergence of phi A equal to what? What is written? Grad phi, divergence of phi A. This is scalar and this is vector. So we can write this in this way. This is the formula. I was telling about that book, that is Vector Analysis by Spiegel, that this type of formulas you will get. Otherwise, from the taking the photo photo from that book, I will post in your group. So divergence of phi A, that is equal to what? Grad phi dot A plus phi into divergence of A. This is the formula you have to remember, and also this formula can be proved. But for this problem, no need to prove this formula. So only remember this one. That is, what is the formula? Divergence of phi A equal to what? Grad phi dot A plus phi into divergence of A. Now put the same expression so in this form. So actually what we had? We had divergence of r to the power minus q into vector r. That is equal to what? Actually r to the power minus q, that what I have taken this as phi. So what I will write? Grad phi. So I have written grad, and phi is what? Phi is what? Just I'm replacing
r power minus
phi
dot r to the power minus q.
So grad of, so how, you know how to calculate grad. Grad of r to the power minus 3 dot. Dot is what? A. Dot is what? A. So A is what here?
R.
R naught, not R. Vector R. Vector A is equal to what? Vector R. Then plus, this sign is same. Then phi. Phi is here. So in place of phi, what I have written? In place of phi, what I have written?
R to the power minus 3.
R to the power minus 3. Then what is here? Divergence of A. So what I will write? Divergence of
vector R.
Vector R. Now, yesterday in gradient, I proved that formula. Grad of r to the power n equal to n r to the power n minus 2 into vector r. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Remember this one? It was given in note also. And that problem was given in your note, and I also told you to calculate. So this is the formula which I proved. Now here, see, what is n? What is the value of n here? It's a grad of r to the power minus 3. So what is your n?
Minus 3.
So what value you will get it here?
Minus 5.
And n is what? N is what?
Minus 3.
So minus 3. So minus 3 into r to the power?
Minus 5
into
R
into vector R. Okay. So here, are you getting this minus 3? Are you getting this minus 3?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You are getting minus 3 here, then R to the power minus 5. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then R is here. So R is here. So R, and here it, this R. This R is here written in this way. And what is this R? It is written here. So R dot R. Okay. So is this portion clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now R to the power minus 3. Is it here? R to the power minus 3. It is same as it is. And divergence of R and divergence of R equal to 3. Now, how divergence of R equal to, see here, the divergence of R, this is equal to 3. And this is R to the power minus 3. R to the power minus 3. So how you can calculate this? Here R dot R, you are getting. So here what you are getting? R to the power minus 5. Into r dot r. So what is the value you are getting from here? R to the power
minus 3.
So minus 3 into r to the power 3. Okay, from this portion, minus 3 into r to the power minus 3. Okay, so minus 3 into r to the power 3, and here it is plus 3 into r to the power minus 3. So minus 3 into r to the power minus 3 and plus 3 into r to the power minus 3. That we are getting the value as 0. Now divergence of r equal to 3. Now I'm just giving you the whiteboard and I'm just doing there. How divergence of r equal to 0. And this portion just I'm showing it whiteboard. Just wait. Now is the whiteboard visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now I'm proving how divergence of r equal to 3. So can you prove this? Divergence of r equal to 3? Can you prove anyone? I'm writing. Divergence of dot sign. This is actually dot sign. Remember, just I'm writing in bold. So it is not properly given. So r, divergence of r equal to what? Divergence of r, that is equal to, what is the meaning of this symbol, Nabla? Tell me. I hat del del x plus, tell me.
J hat del del y.
Del del y. See, I'm writing.
Cap del del
plus k hat
del del z.
K hat del del z.
Del del z. So what part I have written? The first part. Then dot. Then after dot, what is there? What is r? What is r? You know.
X. Xi y z k.
I cap plus y.
J cap.
J cap. Plus
Z K cap.
Okay. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, if you take the dot product of these two, then what you will get? So I hat del L X will operate on this whole three, but as it is I hat, so only it will operate on this, because for this two, I hat dot J hat one is zero. And I hat dot k hat 0. So from the first part, what you will get?
X into del del x.
X square.
I hat dot I hat equal to 1. And so del del x of x. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Then from the next term, what you will get?
Del del y of y.
Plus?
Del del z of z.
Del del z of z. Is it? Okay. So del del x of x. What is the value?
1.
What is the value of this second one?
1.
What is the value of third one?
1.
So what is the answer?
3.
So this is equal to 3. Is it? Okay.
Yes.
Now I'm going to this. Where I was actually. So this problem. Now anything problem you have? So here what I have given, this divergence of r equal to what I have written, the value is? What value I have written?
3.
And r to the power minus 3 as it is. Okay. R to the power minus 3 as it is. And from this, grad of r to the power minus 3 according to this formula. So what is minus 3 into r to the power minus 5 into r, vector r. So minus 3 r to the power minus 5 vector r dot r. So what is r dot r? Dot product you are taking? Okay. So dot product you are taking. So what is the value? R square, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Should I write it in whiteboard? How it is R square? Should I write it? I'm going there. So R dot R, that is R square. So from here I'm getting square, and here it is minus 5. So minus 5, R to the power minus 5 into R square. What is the value? R to the power minus 3. So minus 3 into R to the power minus 3 plus 3 into R to the power minus 3. What is our answer? The answer is 0. So R dot R, just I'm again going to that board. I'm going to my next board. Is it visible though?
Yes, ma'am.
Whiteboard
yes, ma'am.
Is visible or not? So R
yes,
dot
ma'am.
R. R dot R. So what I can write? Xi hat plus yj hat plus zk hat dot. What is the value? Again, xi hat plus yj hat plus zk hat. So now tell me what you are getting. Dot product is there. I hat dot I hat. One. So what? X square.
X square.
X square. X square. X square. Plus y square. Plus
term, what you are getting?
Y square.
From the third term, what you are getting?
Z square.
So what is the value? Actually mod R. Actually R. Wait, not vector R. Mod R. What is the value? Root over X square plus Y square plus Z square. Actually only R, not vector R. So R equal to root over X square plus Y square plus Z square. So no root over sign is here. So what is the value? Is it? Okay or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
R equal to R. I'm going to the next one. R equal to what? X square plus Y square plus Z square. Whole to the power? What? Half. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, so this is R square. The R equal to root over of this. So R square is what? R square is this one. No root is here, squaring the term. Now I'm coming to here. Come here. So what I'm doing? R dot R is R square. And it is R to the power minus 5. So R to the power minus 5 into R square. So R to the power minus 3. So here, now these two terms cancels. Now what you are getting? Zero value you are getting. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now this is the problem. Now clear for you? Or anything I have to calculate in whiteboard?
Whiteboard. What is it? It's software.
Google Meet. Google Meet, yes.
Google Meet, it.
So, is it clear from the whiteboard?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now I'm sharing the screen again. So this is. So is this problem solved? Okay. Now, next problem. This one. So the problem is divergence of A plus B equal to divergence of A plus divergence of B. Prove that divergence of A plus B equal to divergence of A plus divergence of B. Okay. Now the first one. So for this, we don't know what is A and B. So let us take one vector A as this. Vector A equal to A1 I hat plus A2 J hat plus A3 K hat. And what is vector B? Vector B is B1 I hat plus B2 J hat plus B3 K hat. So next I'm writing divergence of A plus B. So this is the meaning already I have discussed so many times, that del x of I hat plus del y of j hat plus del z of k hat dot. This is the dot sign. Then A plus B. what is your a? This is your a and this is your b. If you take the addition of these two vectors, then what you will get? A1 plus b1. You see, you find out a plus b, then what you will get? Combine the I hat up. Say a1 plus
b1.
B1. With this, what I had plus a2.
A2 plus b2 j hat.
Okay. Plus
a3 plus b3 k
hat. A3 plus b3 k hat. So now I have written this term. What is you have said? I have written the term here. Okay. Now operate. It will operate on this in the same way. I hat will operate out with I hat and not with j hat and k hat. Okay. So del l x will operate on which term?
A1 plus B1.
A1 plus I B1. I hat, not I hat. I hat, not I hat. You will get 1, na? So how yes, will you, ma'am. The value you will get 1. Actually, del L, I hat del L X will operate on this whole. This one, I A1 plus B1, I hat. So I hat dot I hat, 1. So del L X of A1 plus B1 plus. Hey, Obi, ask the two. Del del Y. Del del y will operate on which?
A2 plus B2.
Okay. And del del z will operate on which?
A3 plus B3.
Okay. Now what in the next line, what I have done? Tell. Just separating the two parts. All the parts. I have separated all the parts. And then I have written like this. Del, say, del A1 by del X. Then A part I have written one side and B part I have written in another side. So del A1 by del X, then del A2 by del Y, then del A3 by del Z. So written here. Then all the B terms here. Del B1 by del X, then del B2 by del Y, then del B3 by del Z. So all the terms I have broken this term. And all the terms are written like this. All the A terms are here at the first and all the B terms at the end. So now this line I can represent like this. This is a very big line. It is but the same value is the same. This line and this line, the value is same. So how it is the same? Now write I dot I hat dot I hat. What is the value? I hat dot I hat 1. So if you write, what you will get? Del L X of? Just I want to see that this line and this line is same. Just I want to prove this line and this line is same. So del L X of I hat and I A1 I hat. So I hat dot I hat 1. So del L X of A1. Okay. Then del del Y of?
A2.
A2.
Then del del z of
A3.
So these two terms written by dot sign, it is the this term, is it? It is this term, first three terms, and the last one it is remaining. What is this term? Del del x of I hat plus del del y of j hat plus del del z of k hat dot b1 I hat plus b2 j hat plus b3 k hat. So if you write again, what will term you will get? Del b1 by del x plus what? Del, say, del?
Del B2 by del del Y.
Plus?
Del B3 del, by del Z.
Okay, so are you getting all the terms here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this line and this line, they are same. So it is just represented like this. Why? Because I have to prove this. I have to prove this, that is divergence of A plus divergence of B. So what I have done? So what is this? So this I can write as this symbol, and this A1 I hat plus A2 j hat plus A3 k hat, that is your vector A. So divergence of A plus what is this? What is this second?
Divergence of B.
So clear? So divergence of A plus B, that we can prove equal to divergence of A plus divergence of B. So these are the different proofs. In this way, different formula you can prove yourself, that you can write it in this way. So you will take one vector and then you can prove it. So in this way you can do. And the next one, it is given divergence of phi A. So it is written like this, and also you can prove it. What is the time? Let me check. 45. So it is divergence of this phi into A. A is a vector. A is a vector. So A equal to, you know, A1 I hat plus A2 G hat plus A3 K hat, and with this phi. So inside the bracket, I have written phi A1 I hat plus phi A2 G hat plus phi A3 K hat. Okay. Okay. Divergence of phi A, that I have written like this. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, what is the meaning of this? The meaning of this is I hat del x plus j hat del y plus k hat del z. So I hat will operate will I hat dot I hat, the value will get 1. And what you will get? Del x of
phi A1
plus del y of
phi A2
plus del z of
phi A3.
Now you can write it like this. If del x of phi A1, just think the rule of differentiation. So first del x is operating on phi 1, A1 part is there. It is not operating on this. So do you know this rule of differentiation? Then phi is here. Then del x will operate on A1. That is differentiation on both terms. So how you do this? You will differentiate on one term, another you leave another term. Then the remaining term you will differentiate and the first term is remaining. Okay, this one?
Yes, ma'am.
So del x of phi 1, A1 remains, and then del A1 of del x, phi remains in this way. And in the same way here, del phi by del y, A2 remains, plus phi into, so phi ke upar differentiation ho gaya hai, so I have given differentiation on phi, so del A2 by del y. In the same way, the third term. So del phi by del x into A1, del phi by del y into A2, plus del phi by del z into A3. So what I have done? Del phi by del 1, del phi by del x into A1. Then what I have taken? Del phi by del y into A2. Where is this term? This term. Del phi by del y into A2. So this is arranged. Actually, this line, and what is the difference between this line and this line? I have arranged the terms and change the positions, and nothing more here. Only the terms, the position of the terms I have changed and written like this. All the terms here you will get here. So phi is here, common term, phi, and all the phi terms I have written here, and phi is the common term and written like this. And this one, del phi by del x A1 plus del phi by del y A2 plus del phi by del z A3. So that term I have written like this. This is the dot product of this two term. If you break this product, then what you will get? I hat dot I hat, you will get 1. So del phi by del x into A1. Then this one. Then del phi by del y into what?
A2.
Then del phi by del z into?
A3.
So first three terms. First three terms here. This dot this plus phi is here. After phi, this bracketed term, it is written like this. This dot product of these two terms. So the dot product of these two terms. So take the dot product. So what is the dot product? Del x of del x of A1. Then
del y of A2.
Then
del z of A3.
A3. Okay. So this term same. So now you can write easily. What is this term? Del phi by del x I hat, del phi by del y j hat, plus del phi by del z k hat. What is this term? This is grad phi. Is it? This is
yes,
grad
ma'am.
Phi?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
And A1 A hat plus A2 G hat plus A3 K hat. What is this?
A.
Okay.
Vector A
plus phi. Phi is here. Then what is the meaning of this? We can write it as
divergence of A.
Divergence of A. So is the proof? So I have proof. Divergence of phi A equal to what? What? Grad phi dot A plus phi into divergence of A. Understand?
Yes, ma'am.
So in this way you can prove. So I will give different problems later in assignments. You will solve it and you know how to solve. Okay. So today what I have discussed, all about divergence, positive divergence, negative divergence, zero divergence, and zero divergence, that is solenoidal vector. So you can know how to calculate. So if any vector is given, if the proof you have to do that it is solenoidal or not solenoidal, then you can easily do this. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
So today divergence I have completed, and tomorrow what I will discuss, the curl. Okay, curl of a vector. So that the time is almost over. So any problem for anyone? Is it helping?
No, ma'am.
Is it helping you all as I am writing in whiteboard?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Whenever you have problem. Whenever in problem, mathematical problem, or where I will think that it is necessary to do it, the calculation in whiteboard, I will do it in through my whiteboard, and it will help you if you are not understanding. And you respond, all the students respond well in my class, so I'm satisfied with this. But whatever I am saying, remember, you are not all attentive. What I am saying, you are not filling your Google form correctly. So my request to you all that fill up your form. You all will be present in my class, but I have no written documents. So one or two students are missing. All of you are present in my class, but filling up the time of attendance, you are not filling. And I am telling you that this number, this roll number, these roll numbers are not filling up the Google form. So try to fill up the form every day in proper time. Otherwise, you will be in problem. Okay, you will get maybe 100% attendance in class, but your written documents is 70% attendance. And on this total number, that is 70% attendance, I will give you the internal marks. And that will happen. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. So, ending my class for today.
Thank you.
And tomorrow, I will send this note I will send after my class. Okay. Now that I want to say that roll number 16, are you here? Roll number 16. So roll number 16. So absent. So only one student is absent today. That is roll number 16. So I will make him absent. So roll number 16 is absent for my class for today. Now leaving the meeting.
Thank you, ma'am.